Well, we're joined now by registered dietitian with the Grey Nuns Hospital, Ruth West. So thank you for coming in.
Thanks for
busting myths today about nutrition.
Yeah,
there are a lot.
This is the theme for Nutrition Month this year. Across the country, dietitians are looking at some of the myths, the common nutrition myths that we hear all the time, and we're busting those myths with the truth.
Okay, so we'll start with the first one, the one that sea salt is better for you than table salt. What is the truth?
This is one that I hear all the time. When people are trying to cut back on sodium to better control their blood pressure, they think, well, I'm going to have sea salt instead of regular salt, and that's a way to cut back on sodium. No, it is not. The two types of salts have the same amount of sodium. Mm-hmm. Sea salt is different. It has a different flavor and maybe has a different look, but the sodium is the same. So the bottom line is, have less of either kind of salt, table salt and the sea salt.
Okay, that is a good one because a lot of people do believe that.
Absolutely.
Okay, and here's another huge one. Everyone needs to drink 8 glasses of water a day. You even hear 8 to 10 glasses of water
a
day.
Yeah, you do. And the bottom line is you need to be well hydrated and water is probably the best choice to satisfy your thirst. But you can hydrate with other fluids too. It doesn't have to be water. And the way I look at it is you maybe could have half of your fluid as water in a day. Like the two water bottles that I have here between meals would be a great amount, about 4 cups of, or you know, a thousand mils, a liter of water a day.
Pure water,
But then at meals and other times of the day, you can have other fluids, of course, to hydrate as well, including milk and juice and tea and coffee. All of these would count towards your hydration.
So. And coffee does hydrate? Because I've heard that it dehydrates.
I know, and I used to think that too, but actually, no, it adds to the fluid of the day, and it bottom line is it hydrates you.
Oh, okay, that's good news.
Yeah, absolutely.
The next one, a detox diet. These are so big lately.
Yes.
It's a good way to flush out all the toxins in your body.
Yeah, well, you don't really need a detox diet to do that because your body does that every day thanks to your liver and your kidneys and your intestines. So really, a detox diet just every now and then doesn't really cut it. You need to realize that this is happening every day for yourself. Mm-hmm. It is important to eat a healthy diet, but a detox diet is not going to be the thing that actually cleanses your body of toxins. The liver does that, cleansing your blood, and the kidneys and the intestines do that, getting rid of the waste material. So that happens every day, and your body does a darn good job of it. Doesn't need a detox diet to do
and
that.
And it's not as if you have a terrible diet of fatty foods, fast foods, whatever it is, and you do a detox diet for a couple of days, it's not like you have a blank slate after that.
No, exactly. What really counts is what you do on a day-to-day basis, and a healthy diet is important, definitely.
Yeah.
But sometimes the detox diets involve fasting and they involve really strict diets, and that's not really good for you. It doesn't really even make you feel that good.
Right.
Quite frankly, it leads to dehydration and sometimes headaches and that kind of thing. So.
Okay. The next one, a gluten-free diet, which is another big, it's a trend. Gluten-free is what people should do, but that's
and
not the truth.
A gluten-free diet is essential and very important for people who have basically celiac disease and intolerance to gluten, or people who have an intolerance to wheat sometimes find that a gluten-free diet can be helpful. But the bottom line is, if you don't have those things, diets that contain wheat and rye and barley, that are the ones that contain, those are the cereals that contain the gluten, are actually good for you. You know, they have, of course, wheat products have many vitamins and minerals, iron and B vitamins and fiber that sometimes are a problem when you turn to a gluten-free diet.
Yeah.
So it really is, it's a diet that's essential for people with celiac disease, and it means for a healthy life
medically necessary for them,
but not
for us.
Generally.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Some good tips. Thanks for busting the myths.
You can check out our website for more information.